Okay, we are live. So welcome to this year. Happy New Year to everybody who are watching live both on Facebook and Instagram. So this is the first week, and usually the Unplugged project, I'm just, you know, it just gets a little hectic, and then I do the live on the second week, and then I'm not giving you enough time. So I was like, this is the one of the New Year's resolution to do the Unplugged project on the first Monday of every month at any cost. Okay, so that's how we've planned the calendar. So here we have the beautiful edible sculpture painting that was made. And then I was practicing like 4 or 5 times to get this flower, what I'm holding right now. And I wanted to have that proper structure of the flower where we could see the bud also on the top view as well. And it is not quite difficult to scrape this out from here and then put it on the cake on the sides. So pretty much practice the sculpture painting on the board like how I've done. And so what we did, though we have done quite a bit of the setup here with the top angle and the side angle, everything going together parallelly during the live itself, I thought these petals, the placement of those petals are quite intricate. And though even in live, it could be a little difficult to show you how exactly I'm going to fit in the petals in the live. So I thought recording it ahead of time, making sure how I'm arranging each of the petals, so you have a clearer idea of how to work on this. So we have pre-recorded and edited it to give you a proper close-up and the complete process of making the same flower. So that video will be played right now, and so you could take a look. I've also spoken in that video. I also explained how to do in that video. So once that video is played, then again, I'll get back on screen, and any doubts you may have, then I'm going to answer that after the recording is over. Okay. So let me just check back on the comments before we're going to start playing the video. Can we have the live screen so we could just check on any comments if we may have? Not yet. On the Insta also. Okay, so you can start watching the live. We could play the making of this. So before that, what medium I'm using on that particular video is white ganache. So I've been just not telling you guys what this material is. Is it buttercream, or is there any special cream that was designed? So this is just white ganache, okay? And the ratio I have used is 1:4. And the brand I have used is Van Leer white compound. It's not a couverture. So 100 grams of cream to 400 grams of white compound. I am melting the both together in the microwave and then setting that in the room temperature is very important overnight. Okay. And obviously you have to be working in a cold place. And if you don't have AC, then this technique is a little difficult to get. So you need to have AC going on. So 1:4. Now, say suppose you're working with a brand and in which the 1:4 doesn't behave like what I am going to show on the video now, then you might have to increase the chocolate and make it 1:4.5, which is 100 grams of cream to 450 grams of chocolate. So the more you're going to make it stable and more chocolate is going to come, then though it could be a little difficult while you're trying to smoothen out or make the thin layer for the petals and all that, but handling it to make this flower will become easy. So what you have to look at is the consistency of the ganache and the way I am going to spread it and way in which I'm going to pick up the petal and then add it into this to make this flower. So you have to work on your ganache's consistency to the whey, because I also worked with Morde and that needed more chocolate, and that is why I'm insisting this recipe and the ratio may not be the same for all the brands, and I'm not sure how Kovacho will work on this a particular technique. So stick to compound. And if you're using Vanillia, do 1:4. And if you're using Morde, do 1:4.5. Okay. And more doubts on this. So we are using white ganache in the ratio of 1:4 or 1:4.5, depending on the brands. Most of the other details will be covered in the video that will be played. And Geetanjali is asking for a recipe of butter cream. No, because this is made using white ganache, and I'm just verbally telling you the ratio and the recipe for the white ganache, right? So we'll have the video played, watch it, and then I'll get back to come back and answer your queries. So I'm going to take some ganache and then color a portion of the ganache. It is a hard one because we have used 1:4 ratio here to keep the flour stable. So I'm going to keep a bit of white, but I want two different tones. I'm going to have fuchsia, so I'm just picking up some into a bowl, and then I'm using fuchsia gel color. I'm just going to keep it in the little darker tone, but because if I have to lighten it, I can use the plain ganache and lighten the tone as I need when I'm making the petals. You shouldn't microwave this because it is thick, because if you microwave it once, then the texture changes and it makes it difficult to swipe and make the petals. So here, when you have to start doing the petals using this particular technique, using white ganache, you need to make the ganache up front and leave it in room temperature overnight, and then you will be ready to use it for making the petals only the next day. You cannot try to put it in the fridge like you will do it for your maybe working on the cake. That is not possible. You need to always keep it in room temperature, and only then the texture will remain better. Okay, so now I'm going to set this aside. I'm going looking for a nice purple shade also. I'm adding the same fuchsia with a little bit of blue, sky blue. So mix the color properly until you just have two colors, the pink that came from fuchsia, and then this is a mix of blue and fuchsia, and then I have the purple, and I also have the white, which is just a plain ganache, and then we'll just get started with making the petals. So these are the set of 5 palette knives that we will be using. So I'm just going to pick up the number 5 and then start showing you how to make the petals. Okay, so let me start with picking a bit of the white. So they will be hard, obviously it's in room temperature, but that is the consistency and the texture we are just looking at. Okay, and from there, so the first step I'm just going to show you how to work on the petals.
Okay, so start spreading the ganache out, and as you move towards your left side, you need to check the spatula. I'm not keeping it flat down like that. I am tilting it at an angle. Okay, so when I'm moving it towards my left side, I will tilt it at an angle like that, and then when I'm moving towards the right side, I will tilt it at an angle. So if I don't tilt it at an angle as I'm doing the left swipe and the right swipe, then it will not be smooth. Like, I can't be keeping it flat and move it left and right without changing the angle. It is not going to give me a flat, smooth surface. So, and then making a very thin spread is important. I could do towards one side, trying to make it smooth and neat. And each time you can see, like, if I have to do that same thing slowly, you can see the I'm holding and I'm keeping the hold here using my index finger. So I'm controlling the pressure in which I'm just going to sweep it down to the left. And if I'm going to do it on the other side, I will tilt the spatula or the palette knife towards that angle. So it just scrapes out if there's anything extra. I can still put the excess back here and then keep spreading it out towards one side, and then you can see there's a gentle tilt in the angle. If I have to do it slowly and then show you, that's very important. So first step, you should be able to sweep and then keep it flat, thin and neat swipe. The next we'll just start doing the petal. So start using the palette knife, tilt it to an angle and hold your index finger, and then start scraping it and collect the ganache at the back of the palette knife. Put enough pressure. You have to wait for the ganache to set well. You can see it starts to create those veins at the back that you can see. So with each sweep, you can see, because I'm just trying to scrape, giving more broader width to the top and not the bottom. So I'm not going to scrape it from here. I'm just going to scrape here because I'm collecting more and making this wider. Now, if I want a little broader surface for this part of the petal, then I will go and scrape, giving more surface here. So by this, I have collected and gathered the ganache as much as possible. And the next step is to place it down. So that also I'm going to do it at an angle like that. And press it down slowly, gently. And these we could just remove. So these will anyway be hidden, so that doesn't matter. And what you have is this petal. Because the ganache is quite settled and stable, it will allow you to move or bend like that, or allow to open and give movement. Now here in this way, as we are collecting the ganache and creating the petals one by one, at times we would need this sharp end, or at times we just have to cut it off because we don't need a sharp end there, we want it rounded. So there are places where this one petal will be closed like that, or this one petal will be open like that, or we have to move it on the outside and create a movement. And there are times when we have to scrape this petal out from this. You will be able to pick it up in your hand like that. It won't stick. You can see that is the back of the petal. And if needed, you could just thin it down, and if it sticks to your hand, you can dip it, dip your fingers in water, and then you could just smudge it here. And then bend the petal. Here we could remove excess here based on how we want. So the first step for you to understand how to do the petals is to first sweep. You can still mold it with your fingers. You can still here fold it back, or you can bring it forward. So these are the ways on one side of the petal. We just want to understand how this petal can be placed directly, or it can be just cut from the surface that we have placed, and using your hands you can just pick it up from here and it stays stable, and then you can change the shape of how you want it and then go and insert where you want. So we will be using these kind of petals as we will be working on the entire flower. I'm just going to smudge this out and then start smearing again. Now I'm going to use the other side to sweep. So the petal on the other side. So the earlier one I had tilted it this side and then I scraped it towards this side. Now if I want the petal facing the opposite side, then I will tilt it in this direction and then start scraping towards my right. I just need to completely scrape and collect the ganache as much, and make sure I have quite a bit at the back. And this petal I'm just going to sweep it on this direction. So this is a petal that is facing inwards towards my left side. So this is the petal I'll start building from the right side, and so it is curling on the opposite side. So this is a right side petal, and the one that I made earlier is the left side petal. Now this is quite stable. I could leave it like that and then start building another petal, which I will be doing as I show for the flower. Now if we have to pick this up, let's still go and cut it and then pick it up from the palette knife. Okay, and I could just cut the excess if I want the petal to be a little smaller, and then I'll go and place it where exactly I need. I could use my fingers and make it stay in the way I want. So these are the major flowers, sweeping it to the left and then creating the petals to the left and sweeping it to the right, and each of them you will be able to cut and then hold it and place it where you want, facing the opposite side, or even from there you could just make it facing downwards, and then you will be able to make the petals open, or you could just make it closed depending on how you are going to build. Okay, so let's move on to the flower. The pink and white ganache, and created a marble. Okay, and I'm going to clean and scrape the back of the spatula a bit. Now I'm going to start scraping and gather the ganache at the back and create the first petal. Okay, so what I have here, and then now this is the board in which I'm just going to set the flower. So the first petal I'm just going to swipe, and just remove the excess. Okay, so that will be the first petal. Let's just fold it on one side and I've just left it there. Now let me do the next. So I'm going to do one more petal. So this on the same side. This is what I've gathered, and then I'm just going to place it as the second petal, very next to the previous one, and swipe it. There will be excess here which I will just scrape, but I know that I've got two petals that are formed here, which I will be able to open out as I need and then close and start showing the veins that are at the back of the petal. So these are the two petals that are there. So I'm just collecting the petal at the back Now I am going to have one petal in the middle. I have also marbled some purple and pink here. Just see, the petal is just beautifully collecting at the bottom. I'm just going to swipe it here first and then collect it. Okay, and this I'm just going to cut it and make it shorter. Okay, and here I'm just going to place it around here. You just want to place it inside, so I'm just going to gently lift. Then I'm going to put it back. So we could have done that first one, the middle one to start with, and then moved on to the other petals. Here again, these could be removed if they sound to be too sharp. So we have 5 petals ready. So I've sweeped in one more petal and I made it shorter. I'm just going to lift this one and then place the petal here and then put it back. And I'm just going to add one more petal in this gap. Swiping for the other side. I'm just going to collect it, a very thin petal. I'm going to cut the base and have a smaller petal. And this I'm just going to lift this out and insert it in this gap. And then I'm going to start building the center, the bud part. So I've collected the mix of purple. I'm just going to swipe it down here directly. Remove the excess. So this is already curled. I'll just leave it like that. I'm just going to start collecting for the opposite side here. And then come down in here. Swipe it, remove excess. I could still have a few more smaller ones inside before they close, but if I have to close this, I can start doing it, but the gap is a little more, so I'm just going to leave it open and do a few smaller ones in the center. So here again, I want shorter ones, so I'm just collecting it not to the entire length of the palette knife, but only till here. So this is a shorter one which I'll be able to go sweep in there directly. Okay, so that will be the center bud. And for the opposite direction, so you have a shorter one, a very pretty petal, which I'm just going to open this and then sweep it. Now I'm just going to curl this down nicely like that and put this over on top of that and close this one as well, and then bring this on top and then close that one. So you have a really pretty bud that is forming there with the outer petals, which we can still go ahead and then open and close as we need. So we have the bud, and then I'm just going to have one here that is covering this part. So which I'm just going to sweep back again. So that one will not be the left or the right. It will just be the middle one. So I'm gathering a pretty bigger one, right? I'm just going to sweep it here, cut it in, and then remove the excess, which makes it look like the left or right. Okay, so this one I'm just going to open up and then bring it here and then try and cover the bud here. Okay, so this excess, let me just cut it off. Now I'm going to start building the petals around and they'll start opening up. So the bottom is done and the bud is done. Then I just need to cover around. Now sweeping, which I'm just going to place it around here. And start closing it here. Just make sure the petal is tucked in properly. And then doing it for the opposite side. Sweep in a few more. I'm just going to start adding and keep building the flower. The next one, I'm just going to add it here in the gap. So this one, I'm just going to put it here. I'm just cutting it out so it could just be a better cup shape there. This petal, which I'm just go and add it here. We have one more petal that I'll add it here to just cover the center. So I'm collecting it here and then I'm just going to start placing it down there and cut the excess out. Okay, so this will be the outer layer which I'm just going to start opening up and then slowly build. So we have the petals falling down. So this is what we have at the moment. So I'm placing one more petal here. I'm going to create a gap in this part and just go around and fill as I go, or maybe I'll have more space there and then go back and then fill it in. So I have the next petal which I'm just going to place it here. Now if you want to turn the angle, I'm cutting out that excess and then lifting and placing it so it could just change angle. I'm just swiping one petal here and then cutting it out. I just want to leave this one out, so I have a petal in my hand which I just want to place it here. Use the palette knife and then make it go till the base. So I'm just going to tuck it in here. Just I want to place it here facing the opposite side. So I'm just going to put it back in here and pick it up. Cut the excess. Okay. And I'm going to again place it here. Broad petal. I'm just going to sweep it down and cut it. And this I want to have only very little height, which I just want to tuck it in here, but put it really inside. So I'm just going to gently lift. Just fold it back so you see there is a connection at the top of the flower. So I'm just going to use the smaller palette knife and then keep sweeping. So I'm just going to have a really long petal, which then I could just fold it like a ribbon rose. I can just create the bud.
So the flower has been freezing quite well and I've also thawed it down in the room temperature. So I'm going to use a sharp knife, it's a palette knife. I'm going to scrape this gently and then place it on the board. And this I have just used white ganache and it is set well. I've just made some texture. So I have some ganache that's softened up. I'm just going to add that as a base. So the flower, if I'm just going to remove from there and then place it here, you want a medium that will stick both these dry white ganache surfaces. So instead of the palette knife, I thought it would be better to use a knife. Okay, so I'm just going to go in and then gently cut. So I'm just going to pick this one, the petals that are just not stuck with each other. And this I'm just going to place it there. We could use the ganache, the soft ganache. I'm just going to do the same thing to the bud as well. Just cut it out. I could use the ganache itself as the glue here, and then place it around where I'd like. Now I'm just going to use the ganache in the piping bag and then start piping out the stems and then make some leaves.
So I have the ganache in marble shades of purple and pink put in piping bag, and I've just chopped the tip of the piping bag. I'm just going to squeeze in and then start making the stem. I'm just piping in a bit of calyx here. So even if the petals are broken when you are just shifting it, you can be sure that the petals individually are quite safe and dry, and you could use the ganache itself as the glue and then stick it and then place them in position on the cake. I'm just piping in some leaves. So I'm just trying to make the stem a bit uneven, not leave it with the pint rounded edge. Yes, this is the same thing which you saw on the video, and I'm just going to look back for queries if there are any and then check out to answer them. There was a doubt which they had asked, how do you put the flour on the cake? Like exactly after it is done on the cake board, you have to just put the knife underneath and then just to remove it, hold it in your hand, okay? And then because it is not going to be like really brittle, it will not break. Maybe you will have one or two petals come out, but then you can use that and you can apply ganache, like a smooth ganache, on the back of the flour and then stick it on the side of the cake as well. It is going to take that curve and then stick onto the side of the cake, like exactly how I shifted from one board to this board. You will use the same method to put it from the board to the cake as well. Angel, if I want to do it with dark chocolate, what will be the ratio? See, dark chocolate, maybe you should try 1:3.5. But even then, at that stage, now when you're going to have it and then do, while you're spreading it out and then sweeping the petal, the back of your palette knife, you should gather the petal in the way that you see in this video. Now, if you do not have that, and if it is like quite smooth, or if you're not seeing those breaks of the veins at the back of the petal, then that particular ratio may not work for you, whatever chocolate you're going to use. So at that stage, what you have to do, melt some more chocolate and put that into the same ganache and increase the ratio. Now you know, right, of what ratio of how much of the measured chocolate and cream you've added in that. So add more chocolate and make the ratio a little more stronger with more chocolate and allow that to set properly, and then work under AC and do the sweeping action. And that is when you can decide whether you could continue forward working on this, whether that particular ratio has worked for you. So for me, it took me 2-3 attempts to decide this ratio is going to work for me. Can it be applied on whipped cream? You can try, but then you won't be able to play around with the petals. Like you, after sweeping and then placing the petals, you cannot manipulate and curve them up or curl them or put it backwards. All that you cannot do with whipped cream, but you can just maybe put the petals in place and then not touch it. So for which you should know where exactly you have to place the petals. You cannot bend back or slide it in, and all that you cannot do in whipped cream. Can we use gel color? Gel color is fine because this is ganache and there's cream in it and there is already water content in it. So gel is water based, and so with ganache, gel colors do really work. Stable for summers? Yes. If this technique itself passes, you're able to sweep the petal and hold it in your hand. Obviously, the ratio is good enough and it is going to stay well. Live will be saved. Yes, it will be put on YouTube, and I will be putting that YouTube link on the Facebook and the Instagram as well for you guys to take a look. Any more questions? I'm going to look on Instagram. You can make this in advance and then you can leave it in room temperature itself, because this is quite a stable consistency of the ganache, right? So that doesn't matter. But before placing it on the cake, freeze it for maybe an hour. So when you're going to cut the bottom with a knife and then lift it, then you will have it in one piece and it is not going to be too unstable because you're going to touch it and maybe your hands are warm. Okay, the board that I was using to spread is a cake board only, but that was an MDF board. But I basically, it could be the white board is an MDF board that is coated with mica. I mean, it is a plywood, a shiny plywood board. You can do that on top of an acrylic board as well. You can also do that on top of your cake board also. That doesn't matter. Any soft, smooth, flat surface is what you need. It doesn't have to be cold or anything like that. Any wooden or cake board or acrylic, or even your cutting, chopping, vegetable chopping board should also be fine for that. Is it possible to do on whipped whipping cream. I told you like whipping cream, yes, but you cannot touch the petals and then manipulate, put it back and fold it inwards or things like that. AC room is important. AC room temperature, just cold enough. Right now it is 23 degrees Celsius. You can make it even colder if you could just, stick with it. Is it possible to color after the flower is done? Will the color stick? Well, you have to try. You can just thin down the gel colors with Odka Evaprex and then paint on the edges, like maybe with gold or any streak of colors that you want to try. It will stick. Please repeat white chocolate ganache ratio you have used. Okay, it is 1:4 ratio of Van Leer white compound is what I have used. 100 grams of cream Amul Blue I have used to 400 grams of Van Leer white compound is what I have used. Melted both of them together, left it in room temperature with a cling wrap touching the top of the ganache. And room temperature obviously is AC, not overnight, because I work in the morning. So AC was there in the morning. Overnight there was no AC. Then again in the morning there was AC, like so from maybe 10 a.m. and then I started working at 12. And then it was in the right consistency, what you saw in the video. So obviously AC is important and the ratio is also important. After making, it doesn't have to be in AC room because the petals are stable unless you're going to squish it and all that. Now I can just touch and nothing happens because it is a stable ratio, right? After you've done, then you can just leave it in a room without AC. But if it is going to get very soft, then it will flatten out and you have to look out on that and maybe just switch on the AC on and off, like in whatever frequency, to make sure it is not going to completely melt and fall down. It will not, but depending on what climate you are in, you have to take care of that. Any particular size or brand of the palette knives? It's a set of 5 palette knives. I think that is what I used. Sometimes depending on quality, it is not very great, but obviously if it breaks, you have to buy a new one. But whatever is available on Amazon or any stationery shops, a set of 5 palette knives is what I have used, and I suggest for you to also use the same thing. Is it not required to set the ganache in the fridge? No, do not set the ganache in the fridge, because when you take it out, it is changing its consistency. And that I didn't like, how it just goes to really very hard and then I don't want to wait until it comes back to the texture or the consistency I need. And then I'm tempted to microwave and then the completely it just changes and it doesn't allow me to pick up the petals like the way I want. So I prefer to leave it in the room temperature. Do not refrigerate the ganache, especially when you're working on this particular technique. I'm at a cold place in Kashmir. So what temperature suggest for the room for working? You can try and see. I'm working in a 23 degrees, like even a 18 degrees centigrade should be okay. As long as you are able to pick up the petals and then place it and manipulate it in the way I have done, if you're able to do that, then it should be fine. Going back to Instagram to check for comments. So the comments are done. And so this is the first project of the year for the Cakes Unplugged. This is Vashni Ram Singh. Looking forward to a lot of you guys working on this new technique. I'm sure many of you have been wanting to work on this technique. So when you're going to do on your cakes, obviously, you know, there'll be 3 winners, the gold and silver and the bronze. And, you know, the gold winner will get a 30% discount and silver 20% and the bronze 10% discount coupon that you could use it on the Fun Bites School of Sugar Art website to purchase any of the courses. And we give you the digital badges and certificates and a beautiful fridge magnet that holds your name, your winning position and your work. The cake itself will be printed and then couriered, shipped to your address. So all this for the winners, and all the participants will be part of the collaboration every month that I work with on the live. And you will be getting your own badges. Every participant will have your badges, given to you, that you could share it on your social media that you've participated in this collab. So more than all that, learning is the key. That is very important. And so many of you have been, looking forward to learning this technique. So start practicing. I'm giving you a lot of time. I'm going to announce on the Facebook group, Cakes Unplugged with Subhashini Ram Singh, on the deadline of when you should complete and post this. after which I'm going to choose the winner and then announce it. Everything happens in the group. If you haven't joined the group yet, you could just look out on the Facebook and then join. For the video, for you to watch again, we are going to just take off the live from the Facebook and Instagram because the video had a lag. And so the original video will be posted on YouTube and the link will be shared back again on all the groups and the Facebook page Fun Bites, and then again on the Instagram for you to take a look. Okay, so looking forward to your finished sculpture painting on the group, and meet you guys on this particular series next month in February with a new technique. In the meanwhile, January, look out for doing the bake along in the live twice in the month of January. Okay, so looking forward to meeting you guys very soon. Bye, signing off.